Navigation flows are made of cards or a cluster of cards. Cards contain single or multiple tabs that display dashboards, forms, reports, or URLs that allow a user to navigate to specific functional areas in the application and complete planning tasks. Let's look at how we can customize the business process using navigation flows. Planning comes with a default navigation flow. You can make a copy of this navigation flow and use it as a starting point. Before modifying a navigation flow, make sure that it is inactive. Click the name of the navigation flow to start making changes. Each item is designated a type, a cluster or card, and state of visibility. You can reorder or remove items. You can add an existing card or cluster. These are the predefined cards and clusters in the application. You can add a new card that points to URLs or artifacts you created. And you can add a cluster to group existing cards or the cards you created in it. I'll add a cluster. I'll enter a name for the cluster. This becomes the cluster's label as well. I'll set this cluster to be visible. Then, I'll select an icon for the cluster and save the new cluster. The cluster is added to the bottom of the list. We'll reorder items later. Next, I'll add a card within that cluster. Add up to 16 visible cards to a cluster. I'll enter a name for the card, set it to visible, and select the cluster I just created. For content, you can display a single page artifact or URL or a tabular page. Tab pages can be vertical or horizontal or a combination of both. I'll add a new vertical tab. Add no more than 10 visible vertical tabs within a card. I'll enter a name for the tab, set it to visible, and select an icon. Vertical tab icons are displayed on the left side of the page. Within the vertical tab, I'll add multiple horizontal tabs called subtabs. For horizontal tabs, enter a name and set the visibility. Icons are optional. For content, I'll display forms in each subtab. Add no more than 20 visible subtabs or horizontal tabs within a vertical tab. I'll quickly add another vertical tab that contains reports and dashboards as subtabs. I'll reorder the subtab so that the dashboard is listed first. Next, I'll make some changes to the existing cards and clusters. I'll move user preferences from the tools cluster to the forecasts cluster. I'll move the forecasts cluster so that it is displayed as the first card in the navigation flow. I'll hide the strategic modeling cluster. Navigation flows offers three levels of permissions. Global grants permissions to all users. Artifact-based takes advantage of access permissions granted to a user or group. With role-based, you can assign a role or group to the navigation flow you just created. Note that predefined roles, application-level permissions, and access permissions also affect user or group access to objects. I'll assign this navigation flow to the interactive users group. When I hide or remove objects from the navigation flow, all members of this group will no longer have access to them. When finished, save and close the navigation flow. To start using a navigation flow, set it to active. I'll log off and log back on using an interactive user account. Notice that the planner's navigation flow is the default navigation flow for this user. The forecasts cluster is displayed as the first item in the navigation flow. The items that were hidden are no longer accessible. Here are the cards I added and moved to this cluster. The forms, reports, and dashboards I selected are displayed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.